Now, today when we are going further, we would be discussing about the objectives of marketing. See, as I said, no, the first one for every marketing function, the first function comes with identifying what actually is needed by the target group. Now, why do you say target group? Say, suppose if I'm aiming at, no, maybe a cosmetic. So I have to define it, whether this is, nowadays it is very important that cosmetics is not used by people at the younger age. It's used by people at all ages. So you have to define what type of cosmetic, so for what skin type, for which age group of people you will be defining. In fact, that definition is what we call as target market. Or if you are aiming that for male customers, you will say that, okay, this is particularly for, you might have seen that many of the companies come up with separate cream, facial cream for men as well as female category. So that is, they are identifying the target group, specifying. Earlier you did not have such case. You just had one cream, both male and female used to use it. Now it's not like that. They will specify when they bring perfumes. They say that this is for male and this is for female, the brands being, and of course there are unisex brands also, but you will definitely specify for whom this is meant for. So that is what you mean by target audience. I have put a picture of that where you can see that target audience can be decided on the basis of age, can be on the basis of location or interest, language, or maybe spending habit. Say sometimes, no, when you are bringing a high-end mobile phone, it may not be that you are aiming at people in the middle income group or lower income group. You will be aiming at the people in the higher end. So you have to promote, you have to plan your promotional strategies as such it is meeting the demand of such category. You have to plan the promotion strategies in such a way that that will be watched by people of that category. So that is one way you are identifying. And of course, sometimes you can see that the same advertisement when you go from state to state, it is being advertised in different languages. Because if your aim is to reach to the customers of all the languages, definitely you will be coming up with using regional languages for those advertisements. And then you will also know that certain products will be of more greater importance for older generations. Say, for example, like pension schemes, or as you say, insurance policy, which may not be attractive to people who are not earning now. Right. So the companies will be channelizing and they will be advertising on the way that it is attractive to those people, the target who are coming under that category. So that is what we mean by identification of the target market. Because if I produce something and if I'm trying to sell that to anyone, that will not work. So I really have to understand where I'm trying to place this product. Right. And I have to channelize all my programs accordingly. And then the next thing, earlier there was a scenario, as I said, people used to manufacture something and then they used to push into the market. But now it is not like that. Companies will come and try to understand what really is needed by the people of that target group. What type of product is needed? What is the taste and preferences? And then they come up with selling a product of that kind. See, I often say that, say when Kellogg's, first approached Indian market when they were trying to sell their cereals, initially they started offering the product with cold milk. Okay, that was the tradition that they used to have in developed market like Western countries. People used to have that with cold milk. So they tried to introduce a product in the same way in Indian market also, but then unfortunately the product did not get any acceptance. Then the company tried to study, okay, what is the reason why people are not buying? Initially, they understood that in India, we have a habit of certain stipulated dishes for the morning breakfast. And they also identify that all these are served as fresh as it is. People are having a mindset that it should be hot enough. they are not used to the habit of having that, after becoming cold. So the company got the idea that they have to, if they have to penetrate into Indian market, they have to adapt to that style. So the company started advertising that, yes, these cereals can be used with oat milk or cold milk. They started advertising like, you can use as you prefer. So slowly people came into the habit of using that. And now you know that the kind of markets, the Kellogg's, especially in the children's market, they are having it. Most of the children, they love eating that. So the company is already penetrated into the market. Likewise, initially noodles, even now some of us know often like interchange noodles for Maggi, because they were the first brand, not the first, but the first prominent brand to reach to the customers. So accordingly, what happened here is they introduced the product as, when Indian women started going for work and all, they introduced the product as, yes, in 2 minutes. Now they don't advertise it to that extent because that's not their needed. There are many other product options. But initially they said, in 2 minutes, you can cook the food. So that was, they were aiming at a target group of working women who did not have much time to cook for the family before going for the work. So likewise, you have to identify the need and want. Need can be converted into want by giving better awareness, or by giving good promotional strategies, or by offering the ideal product that is suitable to their requirement. So you have to understand. So that is the second most important function. In fact, it is not mandatory that it has to come in this order. It can come in any order. Like you going and understanding first what is the need, then you identify the target market, and then you will see that, okay, you have a product idea of this one. So this will be suitable to this target market. Likewise, you can come up with, it can work in the reverse order also, but generally companies will be identifying the target market, and then they will look into what are the needs. Maybe there is a product like that. So for example, when you look into a target market, you are trying to sell maybe some kind of textile. Okay, you want to start up a textile showroom, and you know that there are many textile showrooms in that chain. So then you really have to understand what difference you are going to create by starting up a textile of your category over there. Suppose if you feel that there is no need of it, then if you go, people will not accept. So really you have to understand what is the need of that target and then offer a product in that category. Of course, the next one is along with that. Once you know what people need, then accordingly you can develop products that will be suitable to meet their requirement, right? And once you already have the product, of course, pricing is one of the sensitive issue which a company has to face. Because if price is too high, people will not come. If price is too low, they will doubt why this price of this product is too low. Is the quality too low? Is the company sacrificing some features just to make you get this product at this lower price? Or is it duplicate? You will have all these. So the pricing should be appropriate enough to represent the product. See, sometimes you might you have a product expectation, product price expectation. You imagine that Apple coming up with a phone for 2000 rupees, will you accept? No, you will be doubtful whether this has been brought out by that company, because Apple does not have a habit of coming up with a product that is for the lower segment, because the company has already introduced them like that, right? They have identified the target market to be the luxury segment. So that is the importance of pricing. You really have to identify the segment where you're offering the product. You have to see the type of customers, the type of competitors. Of course, you will be looking into the cost involved in your product also. Suppose if your manufacturing cost is too high, you may not be able to offer the product at a lower cost, right? So you will be aiming at the target market where you are looking for product. Say, for example, the very good example is in automobile sector. Suppose if you are looking for an economy model car, you can see that the interiors of the car will not be so posh. It might be made of plastic materials and all. It's not so posh as the luxury, but you may get all the features like speed, engine power, comfort, all that. But they will sacrifice or maybe they will compensate the cost in the interiors and other decorations and other extra features that is being offered to the car. So that is what we call as considering all these factors, the company will go with pricing. And then the next is delivery of the product. How are you planning to deliver? That is one of the important function, because now you know that most of the shop owners, they've gone with either WhatsApp, right? If you're a small shopkeeper, you may not be able to go into an online platform. So maybe you have started a WhatsApp group for selling the product and then couriering the product to your customers. Or maybe you have a website of your own where you can sell your product. You have the physical showroom as well as an online platform. So likewise, you really have to decide on which would be the delivery channels which you have to go with. So that again is one of the important function of marketing as such. And then promotional techniques. I already said promotional techniques may differ with different types of products. Say, as you see, suppose if you're constantly buying from Amazon, sometimes you might have saved an item for purchase at a later stage, and you can see that when you take the Gmail, the same item may be appearing in the screen for you to remember. Yes, that's something which it's a collaboration that has been done between Google and Amazon, the using AI, artificial intelligence, so that the customer is you are indirectly reminding the customer that you have ordered, you have kept that for purchase at a later stage. So if you want, you can go back and purchase it now. So that is, companies collaborate together for the benefit of each other. It's a collaboration between Microsoft and maybe if it is Gmail, it is Google and as you say, Amazon or any other platform, maybe Flipkart. Now Flipkart being taken up by Walmart. So any other platform. So that again is something that is connected with promotional techniques. How are you trying to promote your products, or which are the channels that will be used by you? And if you are not selecting a right channel, the problem here is we will not be able to reach to the right target customers. So that is why that again is another function of marketing. And next is adapting to changes means, say now, I'll just show you. I have few pictures to show you. See now the situation, as you know, situation of every country has changed. The style of purchase of every customer has come to a change. It's actually a disruptive model, a change that has occurred because of the environmental factors. So a company which is not able to adapt to such changes may not survive in the market. And it is not COVID. Often such changes will come in the market based on the external factors. Maybe customers have become too busy that they prefer e-commerce. Maybe that they prefer buying products after looking into different choices. So if a company is not able to adapt or equate themselves with the different changes, that again will be a problem. So that again is another function of marketing management. And of course, customer base. You can see that now all of you are using Gmail, all of you are using Google Classroom. So it is something which Microsoft and Google, they have paired to make it open for people. They are not charging anything. Automatically, a lot of people are using their products who were not using before that. A lot of people are using different online platforms like Zoom or other learning platforms like Edmodo. So all these happened because of the change that has come recently. So it has enabled the companies to expand their customer base. Some companies already lost their customers because they do not have enough channel to adapt to the changes. But some companies gain more customers. Say, for example, now when the film that's not been released in theaters, automatically all of you took, some of you took membership in different online platforms like Netflix or Amazon Prime, or as you say, Jio TV or for watching these movies, because many of the movies, they have been released in these platforms. So the customer base for these people have increased. The number of customers using that has increased. Now this is an opportunity for them. If they are using that in the best possible way, these customers will stay there, will stay there for a long time because they are used to. They like the platform very much because you are given with options of movies in different languages, dramas, different choices, all that. And in a, because it's an era of mobile phones. It is available in your mobile phone, right? You can carry it with you. You can watch it while traveling, all these. So likewise, expanding the customer base, maintaining the existing customer, or as we call it as customer retention management, is one of the function of marketing. Now, how companies can do that? When they are trying to understand their customers very clearly by constant communication between them. So that is again another function of marketing management. And the last one is market research. Now, what about market research? Research is always, see, when you go, in your final year, some of you might go with conducting customer satisfaction study for some of the brands, or some of you might be going for attaching with a company like a bank or maybe a financial institution where they will ask you to find out what is a customer satisfaction with respect to their online banking services, or maybe they will ask you to find out what is a customer satisfaction with respect to the products, banking products offered by them. So in all these cases, what you are actually doing is you're trying to understand, or you're trying to make customer communicate to you what they want actually. That all will be part of market research. So market research is a method which is being adopted by companies to understand about their target market and their possible customers in future. So this is said to be the major functions when we talk from the perspective of marketing. And the ultimate aim of all these functions is to have good relationship with your customers and then indirectly contributing to the maximization of profit of the company. So you're not exploiting them. You are actually providing maximum value to your customers and thereby making maximum profit in the in the economy. So if you look one of all of the popular brands like Reliance or Tata or Birla or ITC, all these brands, you can see that they have gone with this principle. They are trying to meet the demands, the needs, the wants. They are trying to understand that through constant communication and arriving at different innovative products. Because you can see that every now and then, it's not like once in a while Britannia is coming up with a new taste. They regularly introduce new biscuits, new confectionery categories into the market. Why do they do that? At the same time, they maintain some of the brands. Little Heart is one popular brand. They don't change it. They keep it. At the same time, they come up with new brands, looking into the taste, change in the taste and preference of people who are consuming it. So that again is something that is expected for the existence of any company in the market. So that all will be brought under the broad heading of marketing functions, right? So identification of the target market, and then you will look into the need and want of the target market. And then you are trying to satisfy the need by offering the best product through the best channel, giving the most possible, or as you say, highest possible value to the customer. And of course, the last part is maintaining good customer relationship with the management. Now you can see that these pictures, you might have seen that something very much related with the present. See, this is some common advertisement which you have seen that our products are available on Amazon now. This is a company trying to adapt to the changes in the current environment. Even vegetables, even supermarkets, they have come up with such advertisements. So this is something which the company has done, understanding the environmental condition. It's a marketing function. You are looking into the environment, you are looking into the current changes, and you are adapting to it. So this is one example which I wanted to bring. The second one, see here, this chokos, the kelogs, they are trying to grab the children, just by attract. They are taking the benefit of the situation. At the same time, they are giving more value. Now it is wearing a mask is mandatory, right? And children, they might hate wearing a mask, because it's a disturbance even we do not like it, right? So they are making it attractive for the children by bringing cartoon characters on the mask, so that parents also would be liking that. Children might wear that. If they adore these characters, they might wear that. So that is something company is planning. They have planned taking care of the need. They know the target segment. They are looking at children, so they know the target segment, and they know the want, or as you say, the preferences of that target segment. They made it available. So this is an example of how companies try to understand the need and want and try to meet that. So in a way, they are also selling the product, right? They're attracting, they're giving an additional value. At the same time, they're selling the product. So this is an example of how you address the need of your target group. And this is something, this is an advertisement which actually caught my attention. This is for Zomato. Zomato, how they expanded their target, their customer base during this pandemic. You know that, right? So this was an advertisement which they have brought in to ensure that they are actually keeping all the COVID protocols. They say that, yes, they are using that from the customer, from the shopkeeper, and they collect it. Then the product is being delivered, and they are also carrying it in the most safe way till the final customer. So this also the company is trying to communicate. Yes, you can believe us. We are doing this. Right. Likewise, along with the government protocols, the company also came up with such advertisements. So this is what we actually mean by how the company is trying to. This is actually one example of promotional strategies. Company is trying to communicate that we know the situation and we are taking care of it, and we are actually helping you to get the best possible value. In spite of all these conditions. So likewise, this is what we are trying to learn in different modules as marketing functions. We will start with identifying the need, identifying the target segment, then offering the product that is suitable to the target segment, fixation of pricing. All these are something which is part of our discussion in this semester. So it is very simple. Why? Because this is something which you see around. Many of you might have seen this, right? Or this, because it's already available in shops. And you might have experienced this, right? And you might have seen, or you might have used it, right? So this is all about marketing. And that's the charm of this subject. No company, whether that be a financial vertical company, or whether that be a manufacturing company, whether that be a service rendering company, no company can exist if it is not observing marketing function properly. Because we know customers, when we look from the end of customers, they are demanding, and their demands are changing. And if the company wants to know that, they have to go with continuous interaction with the customers.